Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Some people are saying, you know, that God created hell and all that, you know. God did not create hell, but hell is created by the men who disobey God. Jesus clearly told us there are twofold. One belongs to God, in which the head is Christ Jesus. One fold, one shepherd. The other one is belonging to Mammon, as the temple rabbis were having the fold, which was Mammon dominated. In that one, they will have a Mammon who is the head, but they will use Jesus to lower the people, to bring in the people, as the Jewish people used it, you know, and when they took over the Church of God, they bring in their Torah, but they were teaching the Torah, but in the name of Jesus, to attract the people, to take over the miracle Jesus performed, all that, you know, credit, they wanted to take it over. But they can't, because credit lies with our Father. If He gives you, then you get it. You can't just form the organizations like Church of England that is headed by Queen, who is the head of Mammon. You can't make Jesus to be the partner in that one. They are still, you know, glorifying God by killing people. Next month, they are going to have Remembrance Sunday, on which they will say the falling soldier died in World War I, World War II, to glorify God. What type of God was that who was glorified? On the other hand, the people who are of God, William Booth of Salvation Army, they say these soldiers who died serving in World War I, World War II, died for king and country and not for God. So which one has more sense? Salvation Army people at St. Paul's Cathedral in London. William Booth is out because he is a man of God. Viceroy of India, Viceroy of South Africa, General this and that, those who killed people in the name of Mammon, they are there in cathedral. Seeing all these things with their naked eye, still these cleric, doctoral priests who are lured by, who working for money, and they become in the house of Lord Bishop, when they become, they sit in the house of Lord to make or to rule country. They still love Church of England. Now, if you go to the wrong side, into the wrong fold, whose fault is this then? God or your own? So if you take the fold which belongs to our Father God, and whose head is Christ Jesus, then you will enjoy life. If you take the other, which is of Mammon, as Church of England is, then you will enjoy hell. And that is why, you know, these people who are bombarded Iraq for no reason. Tony Blair, he was a liar. So was the Bush. They were servants of Israel. Israel hold Mammon. He hold Mammon, not God. So money and media is in the name of Israel. So they told him, these people, attack Iraq because Saddam Hussein is pointing gun at us. And they did it. And look what's happening now Who is to be blamed? Tony Blair and Bush, liars. So this is the situation. You have to go by your own intuition and you will get what you want. I've written something, you know, which I will read. God is spirit and he sows his seed into our heart called Holy Spirit. The spirit of man or common sense that makes you son of man, and then you know our Father God to become son of the Most High Father God. If you worship God in truth and in spirit, common sense, then you are in his fold and he looks after you as we were looked after during the Partition of India in 1947, when my father was in the Pakistan area and 2,000 people of the neighboring village came to attack our village. But before attacking, the headman of the attacking party sent a menial saltless worker, the Marassi, who entertained the village people, you know. He is very, very, very shrewd person. He sent this menial worker, Marassi, of our village to call the headman, who was my uncle, out to bring him over. My father went with him. And when he explained to the headman that Muslim and Sikh are spiritual selves, not the physical selves, who will fight and die during this sectarian riot, but our tribal people, Jatt and Arian, are going to die. And if there is any enmity between our tribes, let us get it settled tonight, otherwise do not get you embroiled in this falsehood and get killed. You know, this is a falsehood. You know, they're Sikh and Muslim, they are fighting with each other, they are enmity, no enmity in religion. They all love because we have one Father Allah, our God, which is same thing. He understood the affairs created by the Satanic sons, Lala Mohan Das Gandhi, who was known as Mahatma Gandhi, you know, Lala Jinnah and Lala Tara Singh, Malhotra, Khatri. They're all Lalas. Lalas are shopkeepers. They are shrewd people. So they divided, they helped hypocrite British to divide our country. And no elections were held when India was given the freedom. And today, if there is any elections, they send a special man over there. Go and watch that country, whether it's democratically held or not. What about our? No shame. Saltless people. Money make you saltless. My father told him, it is too late. So, you know, when he explained to him, you know, these three shopkeepers, they have created this trouble in the India. And he requested my father to go with him to Lahore, the capital of the Punjab, to stop this nonsense. He said, let's stop this, you know, partition. That means he was so friendly and warm welcome he gave to my father. They came to kill us and they became our best friend. My father told him, it is too late. So he came as foe and told his 2,000 strong armed men to look after us as their guests. And so they did, against instigation by the Satanic people. You know, the head of the police, you know, over there, He was a satanic man. He was instigating them, go attack country, attack this village, attack that village. They won't do it. They understood that it is non-Islamic to kill people, because no Sikh will be killed. It's a Jatt people will be dying. So there are no enmity between them. And they same, you know, they sent a military, which was Pathan military, to guard our villages. My father told them that we are Jatt, you know, and be careful not to create any sectarian riots. So he explained to them that we Jatt going to die and not Sikh. So they said, Pathan said, Jatts are our brethren. So they looked after us. See, the power of his word is great. So you need to have confidence in yourself. So my father was going to such a place, you know, which was dangerous. He did not fear because he had the word of God. And so they did against instigation by the standing people. So this is how our father protects us. Once you enter into his fold and preach gospel from the rooftops, as my late father was doing against the opposition by the sons of Satan in the town. We used to live in a town called Montgomery, which was a big town. And over there, the town people, they hated him because they were shopkeepers. They wanted to exploit people in the name of religion. And my father said, no way, you can't do it. So they were not with him. Where he was, so my father was inspector of school, you know, in that big town. But they demoted him because he was not giving any bribe to the officers. But he was demoted for honesty. The sons of Satan suffered during the riots. And we moved from Pakistan to India side of the Punjab, safe and sound. So God protected us, you know, and we came to Punjab, safe and sound. So this is the power of the gospel. Our father does not enforce his will upon any, but first you need to be in his fold. If you are not into his fold, you know, you go into this fold of the Satan, God can't help you. Where truth and childlike hearted people and not the hypocrites are welcome into the fold of our Father. So, how many of you know that Lala Gandhi was a son of Satan? Very few indeed, and they are sons of the Most High with discerning intellect. Those who know it, you know, they have discerning intellect. And they are solitary virgin. In God, you have a free will or free choice to either use the spirit as holy and worship him in spirit and in truth. Or you can be a son of the Most High Satan, as to exploit people in the name of religion, as Ian Paisley of Northern Ireland and Lala Gandhi, etc. did. Ian Paisley was exploiting people, you know, creating sectarian riots. So he had nothing in common with our fold of God. Now the Church of England person, you know, who was, I posted this one on a blog, and over there the Church of England priest, we were furious, you know, that is a very object, which is very strong language and all that, you know. And I, you can see over a very strong language, it's a logic. And but they don't like the thing, you know, these British people, you know, they always think the white man has ruled India, and so they still think that we are slave. And this mentality is still in the British people, that we have no brain, we have, black man has no brain. That's, I've experienced discrimination by these white people. So, and created these, you know, Ian Paisley and Lala Gandhi, they both created riots. So they are both sons of Satan. In God, you enter his fold through the narrow gate, and you need to be solitary of spirit, rejecting the fashion of the world in which lies and hypocrisy prevails. As Tony Blair and Bush spoke and destroyed Iraq for the sake of Israel, their masters. Choices are yours, royal kingdom of God, for the solitary, or follow the wide road with wide gates of hell, as you presently see in the Middle East. Israel is established in the fulfillment of Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. The tears are getting bundled up in for the final burning, expected in 2018. Or soon after, when Israel shall be 70 years old. No one can harm Israel till she is 70 years old. How many of you know this simple fact or piece of gospel that the people in Israel, they are sons of the Satan, tears, getting bundled up for the final burning? Or why Israel was established, nobody knows, you know. And so they are people, Church of England priest, you know, they are making money, more satisfied people, sugar-coated sermon, and how the hell they can know such a truth? No way. Gospel is not for the spiritually blind who follow the wide road to hell, but for the sensible, solitary, having the hearts of a child, free of hypocrisy. Politicians seeking votes use all sort of tactics, and they cannot feed the bitter pill of gospel to their voters. They can't speak gospel, you know, because there was no vote. They can go to hell then. So we are, in a word, seeking their own praises, and not glorifying our Father God. These robed, dog-collared priests are in the fulfillment of Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid temple, arid-spirited, sacked temple priest entered the church of God by jumping over the walls and not through the proper gate where Christ Peter is the gatekeeper, and he would not allow a liar are a hypocrite through. He killed Ananias and Sapphira for telling lies. They built their house on sand, and as Peter tested it, it fell down. Becoming solitary and preach gospel from the rooftops, setting others free of these robed hireling dog-collar priests. When we are royal priests ourselves, the solitary virgin brides of our bridegroom Christ Jesus. Thus, anyone who makes a following, he is antichrist, as he cannot give the account of his congregation as the rabbi used to give. Rabbis were much better because they were responsible to their congregation. They won't shift from one congregation to the other. But these people, more money you offer, hey, I'm going to that church because there's more money and bigger church. So they leave their congregation behind. So who is better, rabbis who used to have their own congregation responsible, are these dog-collar priests. That is why Jesus said in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the present situation is worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Hope this makes sense. And unless, you know, you preach gospel, you can't join hands with me or enter the vineyard of our Father where the true wine Christ Jesus is planted and suck the juice out of it and then preach gospel to the others. I am solitary. Jesus was solitary. So we make people solitary. We don't mind them. Gospel is by the grace of our Father. Nobody can give you. Jesus could not give gospel to Peter. Peter was once born. And once he gave him the taste, when Peter told Jesus, you are the living Christ of living God, then Jesus told him, unless my Father give you this knowledge, you can't have it. And then he became arrogant. He displayed his nature, you know. Because once born people, they can't understand gospel. So they get annoyed and arrogant, you know, when they know a little bit. They are no more humble. Then he start, when Jesus told him, I'm going to Jerusalem to die, he took, rebuked him, you know, hey, who the hell you are talking? Come here. Who can kill you? You make the dead people alive. How can you go and get died? All that nonsense he spoke, you know. So, hope it makes sense. And preach gospel, please. And be solitary. So, don't be disciple of anyone. We are laborers. We are not disciple. The word disciple is from discipline. Only the natural men are disciples of the rabbis, Pharisee and Sadducee. Jesus had no disciple. They are good for nothing. Jesus had laboring sons of our Most High Father. We are the brethren of Jesus. Jesus is not our Lord. There is no Lord in the Royal Kingdom of God. There used to be Lord in Yahweh. Old Testament, but not in the New. Our Father God blesses you.